हेलो एवरीवन, माई सेल्फ प्रशांत त्यागी, लीगल इंटर्न फ्रॉम टीम लेक्सस एंड कंपनी। आई होप यू ऑल गाइज आर सेफ एंड हेल्दी। आई होप यू लाइक माई प्रीवियस वीडियो। प्लीज लाइक, शेयर, कमेंट ऑन माई वीडियोज एंड सब्सक्राइब अवर चैनल लेक्स क्लिक फॉर गेटिंग लेटेस्ट अपडेट्स। टूडे इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक इन टूडेज एरा इज द रिविजन ऑफ मैरिटल एज इन इंडिया। In this video, I am going to discuss the main points like introduction, women and education, health of women and children, and finally the conclusion. So, let's start our video with the topic revision of marital age in India. First, we discuss about the introduction. No doubt that in India, marriage is a very prominent milestone of one's life. Indian family consider marriage as one of the responsibilities of parents to settle down their children at a correct age and time. Most of the time, just after the completion of the graduation, one start getting suggestions by their parents, uncle, aunties and other relatives to get married, although being a boy has some liabilities as this delays the discussion. But for girls, there is a lot of pressure from family, relatives and society, as it justified in certain parts of India, especially the rural ones. Young girls are influenced and pressurized to get married as early as possible. In the 1978 amendment of the Sharda Act of 1929, the age of marriage of girls was increased to 15 to 18 years. Currently in India, the age of marriage for a male is 20 years and for a female is 18 years. Today, Indian women are doing so well in every field, leaving no stone unturned to reach their desired goal. From playing a vital role of being someone's daughter, wife, mother and sister to giving their best in combat roles in the Navy and the Air Force. Women showed every time that whenever they are given the opportunity, they make the society proud and strengthen it. Moreover, our Prime Minister on 17th Independence Day, while addressing the nation, mentioned about the setup of a committee that will consider the age of marriage. Now we discuss the point women and education. In the modern times, as the current scenario regarding women and education is continuously accelerating, women have become more career oriented these days. Meanwhile, the pressure to get married sometimes results in the unfulfilled dreams. The initiative of the government of increasing the marital age would not only give more time to young ladies to avail the opportunities, but would also decrease the society pressure to get married at an early age. Can we hold on for a while and think about this? Marriage can wait, but education cannot. It is also said that if you educate a woman, you educate a family. The rate of early marriage in India has significantly shown a decrease in the percentage, with increase in the woman education. A survey suggests that on average, only 2.5% of women who were highly educated got married at an early age. While women had no education, the average privilege of child marriage was 30.8%. Observing the huge difference, you can understand the importance of education. Due to marriage at a young age, most girls are deprived of getting highly educated and eventually affects their lifestyle in some way or the other. Now we discuss the point health of women and children. A female's body isn't appropriately developed for the purpose of reproduction below the age of 18 years. A study of UNICEF revealed that 27% of women are married before even attaining the age of 18 years. Not only will it have an impact on their reproductive health, but also on their mental health. Another study from UNICEF gives data which is a matter of concern. According to the study, India has the highest mortality rate of children aged between 0 to 5 years. The risk of children having severe health issues and more prone to death are related to the woman getting married at an early age, says NCBI report. Studies have shown that there are multiple cases where women bearing a child at an early age face a lot of complications. It eventually led to a higher number of maternal and infant mortality rate. In the year 2017, the number of deaths due to pregnancy was high as 35,000. We believe it's immensely needed to revise the legal age of marriage so that the woman would have the ample amount of time to get aware about certain things before overburdening themselves with marital responsibilities. Increasing the legal age of marriage would also be beneficial and sensible From maturity point of view, certain research and reports show that after a certain age, there was less heated arguments and better understanding between the couples lead to less number of cases of divorce. As we are discussing the article in terms of benefit of women's health, in my view, increasing the marital age would somehow have a positive impact on population control too. Reason being, if early marriage leads to pregnancy at a younger age, which brings complications related to reproductive health. The same goes with late pregnancies. After a certain age, there are higher chances of complications and risk due to certain hormonal changes. In an interview with the Times of India, one of the gynecologists mentioned that around 10 to 30% of women opting for late pregnancy are more prone to diabetes and 10 to 20% may develop blood pressure. No doubt that raising the marital age would bring enormous opportunities to women, but somehow we are all aware of ground reality. Laws are made earlier too, but they are implemented strictly. No, considering the trend of child marriage, which is still prevailing in some parts of India, according to the Prohibition of Child Marriage Act 2006, the minimum age of marriage of girls is 18 years, and for the female, it is 21 years. It does not declare the marriage of null and void, but treats it as voidable. It means the marriage will be void at the option of two minors involved. Now we discuss the conclusion. Women will definitely give new doors open after the initiative of increasing the marital age comes into force. They will have more time to complete their studies, educate themselves, and have a proper psychological as well as physical growth. It has been said that educate a woman, educate a family. But I believe that educate a woman, educate the society. If we have number of educated women, we all have more eligible an egalitarian society. Women will more aware about their rights. If someone will do them wrong, they can raise their voice against the all odds and can have their own stand. In the worst situation, they can also fulfill their livelihood on their own. It will not only make them independent and self-reliant, but would also boost up their mental and emotional state. In addition to all these, more awareness campaigns should be conducted, especially in the rural areas, regarding education and independency of the woman and its long-term benefit. There is some information regarding girls who ran away from their home to avoid society pressure for early marriage, and eventually they came out with flying colors. Moreover, the revision of the age will be justified, as according to the Article 24 of the Constitution of India 1950, we have all the right to equality. So revising the marital age of women to 21 will make it equal for both males and females. And here I am concluding this article. Thank you so much. I hope you like this topic and like this video. Please like, share, comment on this video and subscribe our channel Lex Click for getting latest update. Thank you so much. Stay safe, stay tuned. Have a nice day.